They're just absolutely magnificent when you see them with their giant wingspan, and that enables them to forage very widely. So they're able to find carcasses that are far away, and they're very effective at scavenging. They're completely dependent on scavenging, so they can only eat carcasses that have been shot or killed or died some other way. They are really codependent on hunting, and so they need to know where the intensive hunting areas are if they're going to succeed on their own and not be fed and supported by the Condor program. They need to be able to figure out how they can have sort of this coexistence with hunting and other shooting types of activities that leave carcasses out for them, because that's going to be their main food source. When those animals are shot with lead, the lead fragments quite a bit, and condors are exposed when they go to ingest that carcass. This was a major collaboration with U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, the California Department of Fish and Wildlife, the National Park Service, Ventana Wildlife Society, as well as USGS. And so we all worked together to combine data and produce sort of the first ever review of 15 years of condor field work and health information.